Hi everyone, and welcome back to the First Garden Series, where I've been showing you how to garden in a quick, simple, and inexpensive way. And hopefully, if you've joined me from the beginning, you already have some lettuce and kale seeds planted that are growing really nicely. We've thinned them out, we've fertilized them, and hopefully you have some tomato and basil seeds growing as well. If you missed those videos, you're gonna wanna go back, jump in, it's not too late, jump in and catch those so that you can join us planting peppers. We are going to plant peppers today. I like to start them from seed. You can also go down to the garden center and get some plant starts. But in my opinion, starting from seed gives you the best chance for a wide variety of peppers. So let's go ahead and get started. Well, today we're going to talk about choosing seeds, when and how to plant, and a special little tip for getting your seeds to germinate. So let me just go over with you some of my favorite peppers, what I'm going to be planting today. I'm planting some sweet peppers and some hot peppers. My very favorite variety of sweet pepper is called a Jimmy Nardello, and I got these seeds from Baker Creek Seed. It's a super sweet, wonderful pepper. It's great for grilling, it's great for freezing, it's great for chopping up and putting in just about anything. It's very prolific. This is my favorite kind of sweet pepper. I'm also going to plant a couple varieties of hot peppers. The purple jalapeno, which is super easy to grow. Again, very prolific, very mildly hot. And this beautiful five-color pepper plant, which is super fire hot, but it grows beautiful peppers, five different colors. And honestly, I use it more for an ornamental plant. Pull off a few peppers every now and then to throw in my salsa, but it's a beautiful ornamental pepper plant. So that's what I'm going to be planting. There's a million different pepper seeds out there. Just go online to some seed company or even go to the local garden center and choose whatever peppers you would like to grow. I'm going to grow three different varieties. Now, how I like to do it, if you've been following the First Garden Series, the quickest, easiest, simplest way for me to do it is in these little peat pellets. And again, there's many different ways you can do it. This is just how I prefer, but do it however you want. Gardening is all about being flexible, experimenting with what works for you and your climate and your preferences. This is just what I prefer. So I'm not gonna go over how to hydrate the peat pellets. You can go back and catch that on a previous video. This is so simple to do. I'm actually gonna be growing some seeds that I harvested last summer from my pepper plant. So I have them here in a little baggie. These happen to be the purple jalapenos. So I'm just gonna go ahead and drop a couple of seeds in each little peat pellet. I'm just dropping two seeds in each peat pellet. That way, if one doesn't germinate, hopefully the other one will. And then I'm just gonna lightly cover up the seed. It's my little toothpick here. Super easy, just push it down into the soil. And there you go. We'll go ahead and get those planted out, and I'll come back and share with you the next step. Okay, I've got my peppers planted, and I just planted one row of each. So that is, let's see, five peat pellets of each type of pepper. And I always like to plant plenty because you never know when one might die off. I always like to have backups. So it's a good idea to plant extra. That way, if they all live, you don't need all of them. You can just give them to a friend, which is what I like to do too. So I've gone ahead and gotten my peppers started. Now, just a little note about when to start your pepper seeds. If you're watching this in the winter time, it might be a little soon to start your pepper seeds, but you wanna start them indoors about 8 to 10 weeks before your last frost date. That way it gives them a really nice start indoors, and I am going to be growing these indoors. Today I'm outdoors because I just love the sunny weather out here. Wanted to just bring you guys some warmth here from California, but you want to start them indoors about 10 weeks before your last frost date. Now, a little tip on planting pepper seeds and getting them to germinate. Something that I found is really key is bottom heat. Now, these pepper plants right here, I planted about 3 weeks ago, and I got them to germinate by using this heat mat. Now, peppers are a tropical plant, and they will only germinate in about 75 to 80 degree temperatures. So this heat mat is pretty inexpensive. I got it for about $15 on Amazon, which to me is well worth the investment because it's gonna grow me peppers, and I don't have to spend money at the grocery store now on peppers. So you can get a heat mat if you want from Amazon or from your local garden center. What I've used before too is just a heating pad, although it's hard to get the constant heat with a heating pad, but I have germinated peppers before with a heating pad and also on top of my stove just by turning it on warm. So whatever you can do to get peppers, bottom heat on peppers, they definitely will germinate quicker if they have bottom heat. So I'm going to take this indoors, put it on my heat mat, and they will take, though, a week or two to germinate. So just keep that in mind when you're planting your pepper seeds. So that's pretty much all there is to it, to planting pepper seeds. Hopefully you're having a lot of luck with your first garden. Your lettuce and kale are looking great. Your tomatoes and basil are germinating. And jump on over to the First Garden community on G+. There's a link down below. Make sure you join the conversation there. You can post pictures of your seedlings. Let me know how they're doing. Let me know if you have any questions. There's a lot of other gardeners on there. We're having a great time just sharing stories about how our garden is doing. So please jump over there and join me. I'd love to see you over there. Also, if you're enjoying this First Garden series, make sure you share it with a friend, like it, and subscribe. So thanks a lot for watching the First Garden series. Quick, simple, and inexpensive, and we'll see you on the next video.